Yes, so we are going to start with that chapter, The Greater Moguls. So I'll just brief you before I read into it. You know, it's better I tell you something and then we start. The Greater Moguls, the Great Moguls. So I'll be saying it in a different way, and but it'll be the same thing, you know. So we'll just get briefed up, and after that, I'll read through it and we'll come to know what's actually happening. See, ruling as a large territory in the Indian subcontinent, you know the Indian subcontinent, how big it is, with so much of diversity of people and cultures, it is very difficult for any type of ruler to go ahead and rule in one place like that. But this was happening during the Middle Ages. But in a contrast, if we go back towards the Mughal time, the predecessors, the Mughals created an empire, and they accomplished which was hitherto seemed possible for only short periods of time. But from the later half of the 16th century, they expanded their kingdom from Agra to Delhi. And by the 17th century, they controlled nearly all of the subcontinent. They took over everything. Just imagine, they were there for 2 centuries. They imposed structures of administration and ideas of governance that outlasted their rule, leaving a political legacy that succeeding rulers of the subcontinent could not ignore. Today, the Prime Minister of India addresses the nation on Independence Day from the ramparts of the Red Fort in Delhi, the residence of the Mughal emperors. Okay, so that's what it is all about. Just imagine how tough and how great they were. The English also followed, the British also followed them. The British manipulated them quite a lot. The last rulers were very weak. Now, who were the Mughals? Now, Mughals were the descendants of two great lineages of rulers. From their mother's side, they were descendants of Genghis Khan, who died in 1227. We have done this. Ruler of the Mongol tribes, China and Central Asia. Their mother's side. And their father's side were the successors of Taimur. Now, Saif Ali Khan's son. He's named him Taimur. Or Kareena Kapoor Khan's son. Taimur. He was a tough fighter, daring of Central Asia. Taimur. He died in 1404. The ruler of Iran. Iraq and modern-day Turkey. However, the Mughals did not like to be called Mughal or Mongol. This was actually Genghis Khan's memory was associated with the massacre of the innumerable people. Holocaust, you can say. It was also linked with the Uzbeks, their Mongol competitors. On the other hand, the Mughals were actually Mughals were proud of their Timurid ancestry, of their father's side. Not least of all because their great ancestors had captured Delhi in 1398. Timur had come in. Now, what were their military campaigns like? They were very intelligent people. How they used to arrange their fights, campaigns. Babur, the first Mughal emperor, everyone knows, 1526 to 1530, succeeded to the throne of Ferghana in 1494 when he was only 12 years old. He was forced to leave his ancestral throne due to the invasion of another Mughal group, the Uzbeks. After years of wandering, he seized Kabul in 1504. In 1526, he defeated the Sultan of Delhi, Ibrahim Lodhi, at Panipat and captured Delhi and Agra. See, 12 years old a guy, right? You have to have that intensity inside you. that willpower inside you that you want to do something, everything can happen. Now, what were their type of patterns? How did he go ahead and at that young age? 1494, he was only 12 years old. 1504, how old is he? 12, and here is till 50, it's 6 years, 18 years, 18 and 4, 22 years. At the age of 22 years, he took over Kabul. Another 2 years. At the age of 22 years, and he's here already 22. At the age of 44, he was the boss of Delhi and Agra. You will see how long-term patterns they will have when I explain you. For example, the Afghans were immediate threat to the Mughal authority. The Mughals and the Ahoms, or the Sikhs, and Mewar and Marwar, how they had a Humayun's relationship with Safavid of Iran, different from Akbar's, did the annexation of Golconda and Bijapur in Aurangzeb's reign and end hostiles in the Deccan. How did they do it? Major campaigns and events. Babur 1526 to 1530. Please write it down. I am not wasting my time here by just giving you a video. If you have a pencil and a paper or a copy, please do write down. This is going to help you so much in your further studies. Again, class 7, very bad. Not the back question answers, okay? That we'll do according to your chapter when you finish. Babur 1526 to 1530. 1526, what did he do? He defeated Ibrahim Lodi and his Afghan supporters at Panipat. I told you just now. 1527, defeated Rana Sangha, Rajput rulers and allies of Khanua. 1528, 4 years, he defeated the Rajputs at Chanderi, established control over Agra and Delhi before his death. Okay, then comes in Humayun. Humayun divided from 1530 to 1540, and then again 1555 to 1556. Humayun divided his inheritance according to the will of his father. His brothers were all given provinces. The ambitions of his brother Mirza Kamran weakened Humayun's cause against Afghan competitors. Sher Khan defeated Humayun at Chausa 1539 and Kanauj at 1540, forcing him to flee to Iran. He left and went away. In Iran, Humayun again received help from the Safavid Shah. He recaptured Delhi in 1555, but died the next year after an ancient accident in his building. Okay, I'll come back in the next video.